Right, so now it's recording. Okay. So before we start the interview proper, I'll just say a few things. First thing is, we'll just talk freely, and if there's anything you want to cut out at the end of it or censor it, just let me know. I will just go back and cut that bit out, or you know, maybe just put what we call a what do you call that? I lost the word now, but sometimes there's information that we can't really put out there for the next, I don't know, 2 to 5 years or 50 years or something like that. So we will just we'll put an embargo on it. So when it's okay, then we release the information. And then the second thing is, usually if there's no objections, if there's nothing to cut, usually I go home, I boost the sound, and immediately I upload the video. And sometimes it's not that easy because I need to boost the sound and I don't really have a lot of space in my computer, so it might take a few weeks for me to free up space, but that's the general idea.
All right.
Yeah. Okay, so let's start with your name.
Mateusz.
In
Polish it's Matt or Mateusz.
Okay. So I can just call you Mateusz.
Mateusz.
Mateusz. Okay. And your age?
30.
Okay. And are you originally from Wroclaw?
Exactly.
Right. Okay. Can you tell me a bit about your education? Like, let's say, in particular, I want to know about, I guess, technical education. So, let's say when you were in school, did you have a lot of involvement with science and technology? In high school, for example?
I was in special class from the secondary school. People selected from this city and surrounding cities. So there was 35 of us, and from the high school we started to some special program, and year after year we study some programming languages, server configuration, some marketing, promotion, etc. But before that, it was only hobby for me. So I started my education in technology when I find myself interested in programming and little bit of hacking, what was my, let's say, passion in my early age, in my childhood, maybe when I was 14. I start to read Kevin Mitnick's books, and I find something exciting in this kind of stories, and I think it's moment where my interest in this area begin. It's also connected with my first contact with demo scene in Poland, with people obviously involved in computer graphics, algorithmics, and some with some scientific background or not. But on the in the area of demo scene, I was a copywriter, so I wrote only letters. I didn't do coding by myself. It was not my area. I wasn't so good in it as other people are. So I'm more like humanistic. I have more humanistic approach. After that, because I was on this IT profile in secondary school, high school, when I was 17. After that, I studied management and psychology, so it was not strictly connected with technology. But at this time, I was running my own company. I started at the age of 16 with my father, so I was self-made IT guy, I can say.
Okay. This special program that you were in secondary school, what kind of program is this?
Yes. I don't know exactly what was the idea behind it. It was pretty early in Poland in sense of development of understanding of the importance of the IT sector, I think. So we are a little bit late. I think it was some experimental program. I don't know if it was continued, but for example, if I wasn't so good in some part of informatics, and if I didn't pass these tests, probably I didn't go to the same school because I was too weak in other subjects in the school. So there was people from different schools, mostly one person from one school. And in my gymnasium, because I was going to gymnasium, it was first year in Poland where this kind of institution works, so I was also experimental in this sense. There was two of us. It was me and Simon. Simon was the guy who always keep touch with the teachers, with the administration of the school. He was sitting in library, helping organize some events in the school, and he always helped to configure the printers, computers, some backups, etc. Me, myself, I was a little bit too shy. I was a little bit a social person. So even if I was good in some areas and I can help, I keep some distance from the group, and I didn't involve myself in almost any school activity. So I need to apply because of, I feel I want to be part of this program. I applied, and there was two of us from one school, so it was different than from other schools.
Okay, so it's not a program that was in your school. It was
no.
So how does this work? You were in the gymnasium, and do you go to this program during school hours or after school hours?
Yes, it started after gymnasium.
Oh, okay.
And it was during school hours.
Right.
So we have like 4 hours of informatics a week. So two times a week for 2 hours. So it was different because we go to another building. It was called Centrum Kształcenia Praktycznego.
Right.
So in the English it will be some practical study center.
Mm.
And there was a team of different teachers from different areas, and we have every week different topic, so like maybe 10 meetings at each topic. So if we finished assembler, then we go to SQL, then we go to C++, then we go to Linux.
How did you like it?
Oh, it was a place full of geeks. Mostly there was, of course, guys. So I think it's good for me that I fit myself in this kind of environment, because for example, now all of those people, almost all of them, are doing some interesting thing, companies, etc., etc. But I don't know exactly if I'm happy with it or not. We have one guy who now is exporting a lot from Poland through eBay. This guy was very geek guy, let's say. For example, he wrote a program on a web server, PHP, which imitates unlimited infinite number of web pages. So in some way he used Google algorithm or some crawler of Google and bullshit it that he has exceed 600,000 web page indexes from only one script on Google with random words from poetry or something like that. So I think it was some kind of invention in terms of analyzing some tricks. the same guy learned how to, he remember all of one of the most known Polish writer book, and when our, I don't know how to say, our mind teacher, wychowawca, when first she promised him that if he remember all of the book, then he will get 5 for the subject. Then when he learned it, she tell him that it was a joke, and he will give him 5, but only if he can repeat and repeat the, some phrases from the, this book he learned standing on his arms. So of course you know how it it has been, it finished. So there were some interesting people, some originals there. I didn't fit in as well in this group, so I had maybe 2 or 3 friends in the class. At this time I was interested more and more in business. So with this guy from the library I told you before, who was with me in this program from one school, we spent long hours in a school buffet drinking cheap, very cheap and not tasty coffee and discussing some business ideas. So it's my best memory from school. So this sense of freedom and sense of openness and possibility to imagine.
How many people were in this special program?
I think that there was my class and some second class. So I think it was maybe 70 people.
70?
Yes.
And you all came from different schools, different
yes.
gymnasiums, right? And how many of them were girls?
Maybe 5, between 5 and 10.
Okay. Oh, that's a big difference.
Yes.
Okay. And you mentioned that you started... Sorry. You mentioned the demo scene. Right. What is this demo scene?
You don't know about it?
Well, I've heard a little bit about it, but for the purpose of the camera.
Yeah. I think it's one of the best thing, one of the best times for hackers and people fascinated by computers, because after demo scene, because someday the demo scene died, some people don't agree about it, all of interesting movement like IRTs, for example, all of them, when a lot of people came, it start to be too much popular, and it's because of losing its exclusiveness, it become more like world around. So whatever that mean, but demoscene was the how to say, environment, virtual environment of people who are the best in technology in Poland, who are doing something with passion. For example, they wrote short programs, very short, like for Amiga, Commodore,
yeah,
which goal was to present the biggest amount of special effect, the best aesthetic feelings about the what is this code is showing us, because this code was used to present some beautiful images of mountains, some fractals, etc., etc. And important part of demo scene was meeting once a year, for example, for a big party, which every group from Poland was presenting their work, like these demos. So the combination of animation, music, and everything in one piece. So I was only once on this party, because I was too young, so I had like 15 years, so I need to ask my parents if they agreed to go there, because of course there was older people than me drinking beer and wine, and so it was not for me something which I was not allowed to participate too much. So at that, this time there was no internet, so we sent discs between each other. On this disc we trying to pack as most of software and texts as possible to impress others, to connect with them, to meet. I think it was something beautiful. So I have good memories from that time, maybe even if I was a little bit childish, I suppose, but I always fit in some adult group better than in my age groups. So maybe this is what I find so fascinating in the demo scene, that they accept me as I am, not looking at my age.
Right. And I guess the demo scene, the annual party that you mentioned, this was in Warsaw or was it in Wrocław? The
party.
Yeah, the party that everybody came to.
No, the party when I was first time and only time was in Gliwice. It's a small town, and there was rented castle for that purpose.
Okay.
So I think the organizer, I know this guy to this day, he needs to involve some city government, culture people to give them possibility to organize this event. So it was like first time when this movement was connected with some other part of the city, because it was starting to become more and more popular to do something with multimedia in universities, for example. But it was the beginning of it.
And when you were in this demo scene in Wrocław, what was it like here?
I met only one guy in Wrocław who was part of the demo scene. So there was no physical connection between people. So you sent discs, you sent CDs to each other, because there was organizer of this group, for example, in one city. And if you want to join, you need to tell something about yourself, about your work, about your passion, and then they say, let's say, oh, you can be part of our group, you will be, let's say, programmer or graphician or text writer, copywriter in our group. So then you become part of some group, your name is published on maybe on web page, it's spread through letters between members. And of course, at this time the internet started, so it was easier and easier to connect, to send, let's say, text files through emails between each other. So this is what we do.
But within Wrocław itself, did you meet anybody else in the scene?
Only one guy.
Only this one guy?
Yeah, because I was, like I say, to tell you, I didn't have the freedom to travel through city, because I was child. Maybe not child, but in my family it is, let's say, you are not treated as adult, you cannot do whatever you want. I can travel on my bike to some part of the city, but I didn't have money, etc., etc., to explore, you know, more, some universities, some meetings. So internet was one of option to meet.
And apart from this special program that you went to and the demo scene, let's say within the gymnasium itself or the other, I don't know, let's say, what do you have before secondary school, primary school, right?
I think we have primary school, then we have gymnasium, then we have high school. Yes?
Ah, right. Okay, so it's different from what we have in Singapore.
Probably.
Yeah, so in primary school and gymnasium and secondary school.
Yes.
Did you have a lot of friends who were involved in in software and technology?
No, almost nobody.
So for all these years, it was mainly just you and Simon?
Yes, once my neighbor find that he can do some code. Well, I remember that there was there is newspaper called City Action. There is somewhere in Wrocław group of people fascinated by computer games, by manga, by Demoscene at that time, like let's say 20 years ago, 15 years ago, and there are some articles about beginning of coding, like Pascal classes or C++ classes. So we learn from that, for example, and my friend from my neighbor find also that this is something interesting, and maybe for half of the year he was doing it also code.
And this was. Was this part of a newsletter, you said?
Newspaper.
Newspaper,
yeah.
Alright. So, this was a group of people who were interested in manga, in programming, in the demo scene, and various other related things.
But mostly the paper was focused on computer games.
Right.
Yeah. There are first paper who goes with CDs in Poland.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody thinks that they are stupid doing that.
Okay. But when was this? It was about 15, 20 years ago.
Yes.
And you were involved in it at what age again? 15?
I can make some small mistakes in aging.
Roughly.
You can find exact numbers of this paper, probably.
Right. What's it called?
I don't have it anymore. CD Action.
CD Action.
Yeah, CDA. Three letters.
Right.
CDA.
Is it still going on?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
I don't know if they are the same people, but I think some of them can be the same. Mm. Like Jedi, one of them was nicknamed Jedi. Second one was Smuggler. They are very famous in the computer, you know, community.
Mm.
There was the best part of this paper. It was called Action Redaction. So there are some letters from readers with replies of the redaction with one specific guy who always repost with his style. And he was liked very much by readers, so I think it was the best part of the paper for a lot of people to read this story.
Okay, let's move on. So after that, you had your own business with your father at the age of 16. What was this about? How did it begin?
It began a little bit earlier, because when I was living in the city center on Haukobusaka Street, it's very devastated area right now, but almost in the city center, there was a computer cafe. So I worked in this cafe, I helped the owner to configure computers, to keep people in order, to pay. It was quite good business at this time. And there was time where was interest in having a broadband connection to myself. So I was trying to connect from a cable from cafe to my home. It was like 600 meters. But this project didn't go well. But the TV operator started to provide 256 kilobits internet for homes, and we bought it with administrator of cafe. We hacked the modem. He downloaded from some forum the configuration file for this modem I had, and then I have the fastest, I think, internet in the city. private computer. So it was some sense fascinating, but of course no one understand the meaning of the the fact of the speed, how it will cost, for example, if I want about it. But then we changed the place. My parents bought some flat in new built area, and then the thought begin that we can maybe we can together with my father provide internet on this new Shedla, new area.
So you wanted to be an ISP?
Yes.
Right. Yeah.
I don't know remember exactly if I imagine it or my father, but somehow it started. My father found his friend company which helped us with the cables, with switches. My responsible was the server and configuring IP table, etc., to share this internet. It was 1 megabit line. Then we have second 1 megabit line, so we load balanced the traffic, and slowly we start to grow. We have like 16 clients. The end of first year, then 50, 100, 200, and we grow to up to 500 clients.
And what happened to this business?
Oh, we expand with Wi-Fi technology to cover quite big area in the city. It was good in financial sense because there is like good margin of profit from providing internet, especially if there is no competition, because there was a place where minor telecoms didn't provide. Of course, there was no LTA at this time. So I started to be stressed by keeping keeping everything in order in this network. Of course, there was problem with peer-to-peer traffic, as everyone who has network at that time know. Of course, there was problem with not paying clients, some problem with electric storms, when some infrastructure burned, for example, some problems with competitors who are not always fair. So it may, it keeps you stressed. This kind of job, you need to be 24 hour a day available for any damages in the network. So I decide to slowly resign of this kind of business and focus on something different, absolutely different than computers.
So when you started to slowly resign, what age were you?
Maybe 22, 23.
All right.
I was studying, and after study, I decided to sell this network.
And is the business still going on?
Yes, I think somebody is operating the network.
Okay.
I still use it for free.
That is perfect. Okay. So after that, you at that time you were still studying, right? About 22, and then what were you studying?
Psychology in business.
Right. In the University of Wrocław.
No, in Warsaw.
In Warsaw. Okay.
It's in the Academy of Leon Koźmiński.
And how was it?
Boring. I start to clubbing with friends. I was involved in some training businesses. So let's say it was time of my life where I was looking for different pleasures and achievements, let's say.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And after that, you got into entrepreneurship, right? How did that happen?
Actually, I was thinking about going into entrepreneurship, but actually, I never was interested in money. What I realized too much, too late, that I'm not going to become a businessman. But because of this first and quite impressive result with this computer network, it was easy for me that to think about myself that I am a good entrepreneur, but it's not quite true. So from this moment when I was decide to go into training business, I spent a couple of years like meeting people, train my personal skills, professional skills, how to, let's say, hack the system of some social clubs, how to approach girls. Yeah, we have actually a company connected with this topic, and this company go actually well to this day, but my associate kicked me off from this business. It was a sad story, but I started to, actually the biggest step after resigning of doing this computer network was investing in the co-working culture in Poland. I spent my money to rent a big office in the city center when I was meeting with people, with startups. I was trying to build some culture, some network around this place and my ideas.
So
that's the next big thing for me.
This is the next big thing?
Yeah, for working.
Right. Okay. How did you get into the co-working idea?
I think it began with a post on a discussion forum, Golden Line, where somebody proposed to meet in a cafe, Coffee Planet Cafe, on the market, to work together in the place in group of 6 or 10 people and discuss about co-working concept. And because I lived in the city center and I spent time in cafes working on my laptop, I was, I think, one of the first people in the city doing that. So it was a difficulty to find the proper internet access in some places. Some the first place on the market which has fast, reliable access was this place where we meet first time on the Jerry. It's called the Jerry. This meetings of people interested in co-working but not having their own office. So it was my first touch with co-working idea.
Right. So are there a lot of co-working spaces in Wroclaw at the moment?
Maybe 3-4.
And you want to, what do you want to add to this culture?
I think I began it in 2008. Mm-hmm. I want to present this concept to Polish press, to Polish freelancers. I do it with my brand, Cocobar. I think I go pretty good about it, but it's very hard, obviously. To this time, almost there is no proven concept of how to manage co-working space to earn money on it. There is 3,000 or more co-working space right now, but I don't know if they are profitable. So my business was definitely not profitable. I put my money, personal money, to this business. To the point where it was not longer possible for me to keep this kind of expenses. And then I decide to go further, especially because of I realized that this movement have great potential, but it needs not ordinary action to go on this wave which is coming after co-working, I believe.
Okay. All right. And you were also involved with the Smart City project in Wroclaw. Yeah. Could you tell me more about it?
First, I have some shamanic experience.
Sorry, what kind of experience?
Shamanic.
Okay.
I was thinking about spirituality and mind, how what we read, what we use every day reflects our minds, how our minds operates. And one day I was surprised and afraid and shocked when I realized that the windows is externalization of our mind process, let's say. And some company is influencing how we have everything set up in our minds.
Sorry, could you describe that a bit? So Windows, as in Microsoft Windows,
yeah,
is influencing the way you think because of the way it sets up its desktop.
Yes.
Okay. And then how did this?
From one side, it's alright because even the language is something which we have common. The same we have common desktop, the Windows or Linux. Yes, but if there is a, as it is, and there is a company who is setting up the Windows for you for like billion of clients, it's becoming more and more danger if we don't perceive it as it is, that from the some small area of technology, which was Microsoft at the beginning, they are going to the business where they are influencing the construction of human mind.
Okay.
So we need to have different approach to this kind of companies in modern times. But definitely there is its topic which is not discussed and by philosophers, by IT guys, it's too abstract for most of them to consider it true. Yeah. But it was first impression which made me to think about creating a new operating system for the mind, for the cities. When I have this co-working place, sometimes we have people who are doing different business in the city. We have guys who are printing some city maps. They have contacts with hundreds of different businesses around the city center, like restaurants, coffees. And I realized that everything is very not well organized. Yes, that there is no one menu. There are no photos in menus in the restaurants, there are no translations. So it's not organized because they don't have budget to pay people from IT, from marketing to do that properly. And nobody can centralize the process of configuration of restaurants, for example, like some open table application. I think there are now application to reserve tables and they are going quite well, but at this time, and especially in Poland, even Foursquare is not popular. So everybody is doing by himself, and what we have is terrible. So from this kind of thinking start my idea to thinking about co-working as place of possible facilitation of process of organizing the IT and marketing sector for places around the city. But it can be centralized and it can be operated by guys sitting in co-working space, maybe under some startup ideology, maybe under new ideology, which is of course smart city ideology.
Okay.
So then what was next? Of course, there was a lot of thinking about some possible danger of when I was having this, let's say, shamanic experience, I was very focused and delicate about some influence, like, let's say, spiritual influence. So I was, let's say, afraid of a lot of influence. And I realized that some movies, some ideologies can affect the communities around me. And it can be made completely through internet. So from one sense, the computer hacking is about protocols, computers, yes? But from the second perspective, is about human mind, like sociology, people behavior, how it is predictable, how to put some ideas in people, yes, and influence their behaviors. And I start to realize that the biggest danger is beginning not in the area of affecting protocols and data, but in the area of affecting people's perception, for example, especially people's perspective of the world, what it is and how it works. So it's the dangerous area of inception possible, and actually maybe very little people know about it. There is maybe some knowledge about censorship, if you want to censor communities, let's say, but this kind of influence, what can be made through internet, through YouTube, through some leaks, etc., etc., it can very interesting affect, for example, the city. So we need to find out how to deal with it, especially if we want to have our kids safe, let's say.
And how did you get? What happened then? You have these ideas, and how did you get involved with the whole smart city thing in Wrocław? Is the municipality driving the smart city project? And did they put out a call for ideas or something like that? How what happened?
No, I was hosting meetings in my co-working space. It was Neuron meetings. I invite there some IT specialists, which I know, and we discuss about ideas, about technology, about creating some foundation to accept or not accept, to give opinion about different kind of softwares available and selling to the citizens. So we test different approach. Once we want to have our own city card, it was called Open4. So we have trying to test different approach, which one will be interesting, let's say, for city municipality. And nothing goes well.
Okay.
Yeah. So I didn't know how to do it, how to find cooperation with the city. It takes me a lot of time, because before I was never interested about government, about city officials. I was giving shit, like most of my mates. Yeah. So, but when I started to want more, and I was thinking more about how city works, I slowly start to collect some data about projects, about organized by the city parties, like European Capital of Culture and this big game Euro 2012. So I was start to dig about this kind of project, and I start to learn how the city actually work or don't work. So it was very traumatic experience, of course, because it was not easy, let's say. So I was mostly ignored by people. Sometimes they talk with me about ideas, they give me some visit cards, and after that they didn't respond. I was trying to invite people from the city to patronize or support my co-working center, and they were not interested. So I was trying different ways. but when I have all my ideas quite well organized, I address an open letter to the city president and people from promotion and from citizens. I made it public, and this letter was about installing a new operating system in the city. It was kind of offer. It was called One City. And I promised that if they will cooperate with me, with people I know, then we can implement this new tech. I have my documents in my head. The promise was that we want to synchronize all people computers, especially the time, because the time concept in smart city is very important, because people are living in different times in different areas of the city, but no one knows about it, that they have different time zones, many time zones. And we want to put people in one time in the city to synchronize the data between people. It was one offer. We offered that we want to make communication between people very transparent. For example, that we can open a searcher for people, search of people with some specific skills or skill set. We don't want to have it as a service. We want it to as something public, which is free. We promise absolutely different approach, and we explain it that because we are not interested in the material profits as a group, this is why we can propose different ideas and this different software than most of companies, because there is different approach when you need to have some point of profit of your system than if you are proposing system which is profit free, let's say, open source, for example. So it was beginning of interesting process, because formally nobody answered to this letter. I even sent it to a professor who was responsible for actual strategy of the city. It's called Wroclaw 2020 Plus. I met with this guy on Polytechnic in the city, and we discussed about these ideas, but he didn't help me in anything. Mm-hmm. So I was still alone with it. At some point I found a foundation in Wrocław. When I get to the webpage of this foundation, ip.org.pl, I don't remember if I was drinking something or what, but when I read the goal of this foundation and their vision, I was so fucking fascinated by it that I called them. I was so surprised and so happy that they accept me on the meeting that I ran to them. Even if they are in different part of the city, I ran. I was wet when I get there on this first meeting, but I was so fascinated by what I read on their webpage. And from that time we are slowly with ups and downs cooperating and do some things together. Coming back to the offer, after which some interesting things start to happen. I met people in the city cluster of creative companies. I met with a coordinator of the cluster. It was Marcelo Murgia. This guy was from completely different environment. He was Italian, so he has completely different approach than most of city officers. He was open, kind, supportive, so completely opposite, let's say. And he listened my ideas. At the moment when I explained to him that the city can profit from selling smart city system, he started to be interested, and he connected me with people from a cluster who run some agency, creative agency. And then I met Piotr Sypuła and Łukasz Łysik, And I spent 1 year with these guys, writing some projects about smart city, because one of these guys was also visionary as me, even maybe better than me. So it was pleasant to work with them, but of course all of us have problem with girls, with wives, with life in general. So it was sometimes problematic, but we prepare at least two big projects for the city administration. One was meant to be a platform for universities to create a game when students can create like shared projects in environment of game, let's say game with the professors and using the capacities, not used capacities of university buildings and other resources. The platform was called Osada Twórców, and this project is still beautiful, even if it has 3 years. There is nothing like that in the world, I believe. And the second project was Wroclaw Life, and we was trying to explain and create the concept how to create the city heart. So some data set, some database, some methodology, how to connect all of data from the city, like calendars, like events, like place, like everything, and how to do it to open some APIs for providers of application from the city, to give the startups and this community ability to build on this interface some different application and games based on the city. So we offer this concept to the city, and then communication was cut with them. After 3 years, I get the official letter. I force it that they didn't give us any answer because they have some changes between institutions and they have no time, and they are sorry, but they didn't accept our offer. But I get this answer 3 years after we sent the offer about this, let's say, smart city concept, because it's, I think, it's very important part of smart city to connect talents on universities and focus these people on projects which are to support the development of the core of the smart city system.
When did you send them the proposal?
What month we have now?
When did you send them the proposal?
3 years ago, something like that.
3 years ago from now, so that
yes.
Was 2013.
Yes.
And they only gave you the reply this year.
Yes.
Wow. It's pretty long.
In Wroclaw, it's I think not so odd.
Okay.
Because how we need to realize that all we are talking about, it's not the software. Yeah, we are talking about influences, relations between people, about policies. I think we was trying to how to say, we have this pyramid. Yes. And what I believe is that the pyramid is going to be opposite from now in the society, that even when artist was pure in the history, in the future artist will be the richest because of the possibility to create, not recreate and compile. And it's becoming more and more needed skill in the society. And there was always a middleman. Even if the art, in art, if you paint some beautiful painting, you need to give this to the gallery, and behind the gallery there is big fat guy with big safe with like oil money or something like that, and you cannot do it by yourself, cannot sell it on the streets. Yeah, but now slowly and slowly through the technology, the artists are like connected directly to the audience. Mm. The YouTube is not the best example, but slowly, for example, there is an artist, Ryan Leslie, who is also a businessman in the startup community, and he create a platform when the artist can be in touch directly with all the listeners of his music, and he provide this music directly to the fans, and he has maybe smaller group of fans than on YouTube, but they are more loyal, and he can sell them clothes, etc., invite directly to the party, and don't have this Vevo, for example, thing.
That's true. Okay, let's move on a little bit. You are involved in what I can only describe right now as a sort of alternative economy. Could you tell me more about that?
Yeah. When I realized that our project in financial system will be not so popular because we, for example, won't open data and access people to each other, so of course there is no possibility to earn money of being connected between people and or on taxing relations between people, there should be completely different law of money, let's say. And because imagine if you have a system which can support all the city in the most important technology, even banks, who will pay you for it? If you are providing technology where finance are not transferred. So we don't need external money to create platform. Especially that the problem is not the money, but people's imagination and limits and paradigms. We cannot create platform which we need to sell people and teach them how it works and force the platform on people. We only can create platform which will be the natural extension of people's needs shown by tech. We can facilitate the process, yes, but we don't want to be the owner of the tech. So if we get money from the financial institution, there cannot be such a policy. There always need to be some small group knowing what's behind, and there need to be something behind. But if there is something behind, there is a scare.
Sorry, what do you mean?
If you don't know what is behind the code, which are you using, yeah, who is behind, who is operating, like we have on Facebook, you know what is behind?
You mean the code?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The server, everything.
Yeah.
You don't know.
Nobody thinks about that.
You don't know what is behind.
Yeah.
So there is imagination. Maybe there is NSA, maybe there is blah, 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 blah. Who needs that? If the technology is transparent and you know that there is nothing behind, there is your code behind and your server behind, nothing else, you can feel different, you can feel better about it, and you can use the technology to more important things. You can transfer money and energy directly through the chat, for example, because there is nothing to be afraid of. There is no separation, platform and we, Facebook and community. There is only community with platform within the community. So the concept is to create 15 million of actions of this whole platform, like in the market, let's say. So there is 15 million of actions which keep all the energy, all the value of the whole technology. So I want to share these coins, let's say, these golds, with people who will be part of the system and creator of the system.
Okay.
Musimy wyjść. Chyba mamy jeszcze zajdzie?
10-15 minut możemy?
So we have to end.
15 minutes.
15 minutes, okay. Right. So in brief, who else is involved in these 15 million actions?
Yeah, it's funny because you need to understand little bit. I think there is no book about it, how the history technology works.
Yeah.
Because history is technology.
Okay.
I give you an example. If I give somebody in 2013 something which I know it will be value in 2017, let's say 200 million Polish zloty. Yeah? I know it at the beginning, but the person I give it didn't know about it because it needs to have a lot of data, a lot of feelings. It needs somebody to believe in some very complex idea and possibility of it, this idea to happen. So by giving somebody something so valuable, you are making this person part of history.
Okay.
Because how we know, for example, from books, yeah, if somebody is part of somebody famous or important history, this person can have his own part of or his own perspective on the important history and made his name by this. So you can support, if you are sure that you will succeed, you can give a lot of people you find valuable possibility to succeed also at the same time. So if my action will be, let's call this new currency my actions, my personal currency. This is something I bring to life. Yeah. If I share it with somebody and it will grow, value of every action will grow,
right.
I can make somebody rich. Of course, if I fail, the action are worthless.
So how does this work? Are there other people in Wroclaw who are involved in this kind of economy?
I prefer not call it economy right now. It's complex configuration to make something which is not possible.
Okay.
You need to create possibilities. You need to fight on possibilities to something to happen. And if you don't have other options, you spend a lot of time, a lot of energy to create potential possibilities. So I am connected with a lot of people who are like very bright thinkers, visionaries, crazy people. I know very lot of kings and Caesars and people from different planets, because you can find this kind of people during your way, if it's not typical way. So, but in the crazy people, there is always a big part of genius behind it, because there are people who are not believing what other people are believing. They are believing in something else, but there is some logic behind it. And sometimes this logic can learn you a lot. So this is like a lot of experience behind what I'm doing. And sometimes I perceive myself as somebody who is on the tectonic plate. So I am on the first line. So I am pushing the system personally, because I am involved. I am putting my name on it. I spend my money on it. I spend my time, my life. I'm giving my life to this idea to happen. But I think slowly I am beginning to be some kind of director of the process of transformation. And of course, it's mostly mental transformation in people's minds, in Poland, for example, because let's be concrete. In Poland, people have a lot of problems with minds, because they are attacked by some forces from years to now. Sometimes even you can say that Polish people are slaves to the capitalists. and have only media who are controlled by other countries. So they don't have their own perspective on the world. So they are in some bubble and they are cheated from any side almost. So it's very hard to give them the direction and some right patterns of thinking about themselves. But in the same times, we are almost the one of the wealthiest country in the world. We have plenty of resources. And this is probably the reason why we are forced to think that we don't have nothing but debt, which is not true.
Okay, unfortunately, we kind of have to wrap up. But so last question. I've been the one asking the questions here, but let's say if you were the one asking the question, what would you want to know about the tech scene or the startup scene in Poland?
As somebody from other country?
Let's keep it open. Like if you wanted to know one thing about the startup scene in Poland, what would you want to know?
I want to know where I should go to connect, how to enter the scene.
Okay.
Because I give you my imagination. Because the, like, let's say this elite of people from tech, if they are people who are bright enough to create the platforms for other people, they are enough global thinking to connect with other countries with similar thinking people, they are enough brave to travel, yeah, but it should be people who have high culture, like high internal culture, to communicate, to support others, to listen of others, to understand other people. So these people, I suppose, would create their own system in the city, like connected with places, with solutions, with services, and the system should be possibly the best for this kind of people in the measure of how much time you need to start interesting conversation. Obviously, I want this time to be the shortest possible from my beginning to the city to the first conversation, which will bring me more understanding of the businesses, the city, the problems, the solutions we can share. So I want this time to be the shortest possible when I enter the city.
Right.
So where is the beginning?
Okay, I think that's a really good question.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for the interview.
Thank you.